so I wouldn't let go.
Good morning. It's been
anybody
a while.
Anybody in here ever felt like giving up? Just throwing in the towel, just giving up. I'm not going to ask you to hunt anybody, but just look at them. That person you're looking at is here tonight only because of God's mercy and his grace. Somebody ought to just tell God, thank you for your mercy and your grace that kept me.
Good morning, flawless beauty. How are you? Good to see you. I mailed your gift out yesterday, so you should be seeing it sometime this week. I was just coming on, give a little inspiration this morning. Today's inspiration is on never changing. His unfailing love for us is powerful. The Lord's faithfulness endures forever. Praise the Lord. If there is one thing we know, it's that nothing stays the same. Life is an uncertain thing, changing from moment to moment. However, no matter what changes you go through in life, no matter how it ebbs and flows, there is one thing you could count on. The Lord and his faithfulness. Simply put, God's faithfulness endures forever. He is always there for you, and he's devoted and true. Lord, I'm amazed by your faithfulness. I know that when the rest of my life feels wobbly and unsteady, you are someone I can count on to be a constant thing in my life. You hear the music in the background? I'm here today because God kept me. I'm telling you, I go through things every single day. This week, I seem like I had gone through it even more. But God kept me through the week. He woke me up yesterday. I really was supposed to go to work. But God had me sit down and say, listen, I'm here for you. Whatever your needs are, I will supply your needs. But rest your body. You work 7 days a week. Even, you know, when God made the earth, he took a day to rest. So I implore you, if you are a hard worker as I am, just take a day to rest. No matter what's going on in your life, God will fix it for you. He fixed it for me. And I have my days and things that go wrong in my life and things that I do. But I always have God that I could go through. When I woke up this morning and I was cleaning up my house, I just said, thank you, God, for it all. But no matter what I'm going through, when I was going through it, he comforted me. And, you know, I thought, you know, once in a while, like, I think that, you know, maybe I shouldn't be, you know, on YouTube giving inspiration. Good morning, Karen. But God put in my heart that if it's just one person that is touched by his word, then you're doing the right thing. So I have to listen to what God says to me. Because someone out there is getting his word that wouldn't normally get it. You know how hard it is when you're in the world to pick up a Bible, to even pick up an inspirational book? Then we miss the message. But God is not going to let us miss this message today. He's never changing, and he is always there for us, no matter what. And he says there's nothing too big for you to ask for God for. Nothing too big. And there's nothing too small for you to ask the Lord for. And that's what I'm depending on this morning. You know, Karen and Flawless, you know, just, you know, continue to live your life and just believe that we have a protector there to protect us through it all. To protect us through it all. And when it seems like, you know, nothing is being done, that's when God is really working. I'm telling you myself, this week, I was challenged in every direction. I don't bother anyone. I don't talk about anyone. You know, I'm not about negativity. I'm always trying to inspire. But the devil tried to find his way in, you know, to get me, to take me out of my character. And I had to go to God and I had to say, listen, I said, God, you sit high and you know what's low. And these people are trying to take Classy Jay or Janet, whichever you prefer to call me, out of my character. But you know what? I'm praying for your strength today. And I'm praying that whoever these people are in my life who's trying to take me out of my character, that you just give them a blessing today. See, I don't curse anyone. If there's anybody who hates me, dislikes me, doesn't want to be around me, that's fine. I let God deal with them. And God says, when you touch his, then you have something to worry about. You don't touch his disciples. You don't touch his people. And when people are not bothering you, just leave them alone. You know, there's some people in this life who are miserable, 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 miserable. They wake up miserable. They feel, you know, if they would just get on their knees and pray, it would make a difference. But these people, if they don't have negativity in their life feels worthless. I'm the opposite. I want to wake up positive and I want to go to bed positive. So, you know, whoever they are, those people in your lives, you know, we all have them who try to stir the pot. Just pray for them. So that's what I had to do this week. And lastly, in this reading, we can put our faith in God because he is steadfast. He never changes, and he tells us he will be faithful. Because of that, we know it to be true. After all, he's a God who keeps his promises. When you are filled with worry or fear about upcoming changes, you can rest assured that God will be faithful to show you his unfailing love. God, thank you for loving me without fail. And for remaining faithful forever. Today, what devotion looks like to me is just, you know, you got to stay in that peaceful place no matter who tries to take you out. Whether it's somebody at work, whether it's somebody in your family, whether it's, you know, just a stranger. You know, they all happen. Yesterday, I was, this is the perfect situation. After I went to the post office, I decided, let me stop at Dunkin' Donuts, buy me some donuts and coffee for breakfast. There was this lady on her phone, and she was on the line, so I didn't think that she really wanted donuts. So I went in front of her, in between her texts, she didn't see me move in front of her. But I tell you, this lady went berserk because I went in front of her. And she started blowing her horn, cursing me out, F this, be that, you know, every word that came out of her mouth. And it was not me at all. If she knew me, I am a person of love, forgiveness, I inspire. You know, I felt that this woman wanted some extra time on her phone. And, you know, and there was nobody at the window. She cursed me out. She went even further. She followed me to the UPS store. I also went to the UPS store, and she sat outside the UPS store while I was in there doing my business and stuff, and came out. She was still out there, still angry, still cursing. You know, that's it. I said, Jesus, you know, you take the wheel, because I don't know this person. So it doesn't have to be someone close to you. It could be someone who you don't even know to start some mess. If she would have had a gun, she would have killed me. That's how angry this lady was. But I realized that it wasn't me that that lady was angry at. People wake up miserable and they can't deal with their own lives, so they have to take it out on someone else. When I feel like that, I have someone to go to. I could go to the throne. I could go to God. I could get on my knees and I can ask him to help me. And that's what I do. And I implore you today. And yes, God, Karen Johnson, God is a way maker. And, you know, during this pandemic, it's been me and my children and YouTube and you. Karen Johnson, Flawless, and you guys. It's just been us. You know, I have very little interaction with the outside world. So now is really praying time. It's really praying time. We are in the midst of this pandemic, and it's worse than when it started. So if you have a sister, you have people here on YouTube, you don't know what they're going through, hold them up. Be that sister to them. Show them love. They will remember. I will remember. When we get out of this pandemic, I'm going to want to meet y'all. I'm going to jump on a plane or whatever, a bus, or wherever, or however to get to you. I would love to come and see you guys. And I thank you this morning for coming, for the inspiration and taking the time out of your busy schedules to join me this morning. I love you guys, and I thank you so much. Just know that you are not only subscribers, you are my sisters. And I mean that. You are my sisters. And I thank you. Flawless, you've been there from the beginning. I love you. Karen, you have been there. I love you. I thank you. Like God said, if it's only one person, still lift my name up. And I will. I made that promise to God, and I'm going to keep it. I want you guys to have a blessed day. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. And, you know, I'll be seeing you over the holidays. But just remember, Classy J says, happy holidays. I love you. I love you guys. And I will see you soon. And if you don't mind, I want to hold on to your addresses once in a while to send just a card just to say hello, how you doing? And how are you making it in the pandemic? As I said, we're sisters. You know, this is way beyond, you know, just social media. I look at you ladies as my sisters, and I thank you. And I'm glad that you're here this morning, and I'm glad that you heard the inspiration. And I'll be thinking of you ladies today. And I hope you enjoy your gifts when it comes this week. It should be there by Wednesday, because I did part of my sending out packages at the UPS store, and the other part I did through the mail. But this week I wanted it to arrive before Christmas, so around Christmas time you could think of me, and I'll be thinking of you guys. You know, that video from the other night, Name That Tune, that's gonna be going up today, because we have some very good memories on that, and I really loved that night. And I love the sharing, and I love the togetherness that we had. So, I love you ladies. Have a great day, and I'll see you soon. Classy J is out.